The next type of typecasting is, as you must have already guessed it, the opposite of implicit, which is explicit. The word explicit means the programmer himself says forcibly, or please convert this lower data type into the upper data type, or upper data type into lower data type, or whatever it is. Alright. So when we're talking about typecasting, that is the explicit data type casting, it helps to just take a look at a simple piece of a programming code to understand the concept behind explicit data typing. Suppose I have an integer variable I whose value is 10. I have got another variable j, also of the type integer, whose value happens to be 20. Then I have got a variable of the floating point type called as result. Although result is of the floating data type, if I do I upon j, since both I and j are integers, the result of integer division is also going to be an integer. Even if I do an integer multiplication, the result is going to be an integer. So when I divide I by j, 10 by 20, it is not going to be 0.5, it is going to be 0, because in integer division there is no fractional parts. So if you want to just verify that, if I print only two decimal places, it's going to print result as 0.00. Now suppose you decide that is not what you wanted. You wanted the result to be in form of a real number or a floating point number. Then what you can do is, you can say result is forcibly typecast I to float. So here what happens is, by using this typecasting in bracket called as float, I now is converted to 10.00. Because one number is in float, C will implicitly convert J also into float for you. Now both of them will internally turn out to be real or floating point numbers. Now if you try to divide it, okay, and print to two decimal places, it's going to print 0.50. So I hope this clarifies your understanding of what exactly is an explicit data type conversion. Here the float is only acting on the I, it is not acting on the other part. But since I becomes a floating point number, J also ends up becoming a floating point number. And that's when you go about and you print the result, you're seeing a 0.50 now. Let's try to have a little more understanding of this particular problem. So assume I'm working on a machine. Just for the sake of an example, the size of an int happens to be just 2 bytes. Since it's a signed int, the maximum capacity is 32,667. Okay, that is the upper limit of it. But what I'm doing is, I'm declaring a variable called as long result. I have int I is equal to 200, j is equal to 2000. Now if I multiply I by j, it'll somewhere come around 4 lakh, which result, being a long type of variable, should be able to easily store it. But on the right side, the multiplication which occurs is between two normal integer variables whose limit is 2 bytes. Therefore, 4 lakhs is going to overflow on the right side. The overflow value is going to go to result. So this is incorrect if what you wanted was the result to be stored correctly in this variable called as result. Now, how do you solve this problem? Quite easy. What you can do is, you can do something like this. You can say result is typecasting long I. That means I is now forced to become a long type of a variable. When I is a long, the multiplication can only happen when j is also a long. So implicitly the compiler converts j also into a long type of variable. So now multiplying two long variables on the right hand side is not a problem. Now it is going to be a long type of result. I is converted to long, j also upgrades to long. Since typecast has the highest precedence compared to even multiplication, typecast, if you look at that operator table which we did a walkthrough, this typecasting has higher precedence than any other operators. So that's why that happens first. Now just to see that you don't make a mistake, look at the next one here. Now I'm saying result is equal to long I into j. This is not correct, because in the bracket the multiplication has already happened between two integers. And once the multiplication happen as integers, you trying to change it to long makes no difference, because the overflow has already been caused. So it is wrong, because the overflow after the multiplication as int has happened. So this is the right way, this is the wrong way. All right. So just be careful when you're trying to do a type casting, or what you expect should really be very conceptually clear. I can just show you one more simple piece of an example. I think I had shown you earlier. So if you wanted the result to be in float, okay, assuming I was float, you can do something like this. You can say 1.0 upon 9.0. So this, or let me give you a better example. Let's say float is I, and I wanted to divide 100 by say 3. So what I can do is I can type 100 up here, but below if I make this as 3.0, this indicates that make 100 also as a floating point or real number, then this becomes 100.0, and then the division leads to 33.333, whatever is the answer. So this already we have dealt with during when we are discussing arithmetic expressions in the earlier phase. So just be sure you have a good conceptual understanding of what is implicit, what is explicit type casting.